Hello, my love. I am Axini, and I have a beautiful bedtime story for you today. More calm stories and more magical worlds are waiting for you on my channel. So, click the button below this video and subscribe to my channel now. You will find stories suitable for all ages, and they are all safe for kids. One more thing. Please find and click the like button now because later on, you know, you might fall asleep. So let's get started. Kangaroo and Wallaby. Once upon a time, in the heart of Australia, there lived two best friends, a wallaby named Wally and a kangaroo named Skip. Wally was small and furry with big round ears and a long tail, while Skip was tall and muscular with brighter fur. They were the closest of friends and loved to explore the world together. One day, they decided to embark on a great adventure and explore three different states of Australia. First, they headed to Queensland, where they were amazed by the beauty of the tropical forests and the waterfalls. Wally was particularly excited because he had never seen a waterfall before. They also found many tropical fruit trees and had a feast of juicy mangoes and sweet pineapples. Wally was in heaven and couldn't stop eating. One day, Wallaby and Kangaroo stumbled upon a large river. To their surprise, they encountered a massive crocodile sunbathing on a rock in the middle of the river. The crocodile, with its powerful jaws and razor-sharp teeth, was truly a formidable sight. The friends felt a bit nervous and wanted to keep their distance, but the crocodile seemed friendly enough. He even started chatting with them about the local weather. The crocodile told them about all the different types of fish and birds he had seen in the area, as well as the lush tropical forests that surrounded the river. Despite their initial apprehension, Wallaby and Kangaroo soon became fascinated by the crocodile's tales, and they listened intently as he shared his knowledge and experiences with them. Before they knew it, the sun was setting, and it was time for the two friends to move on. They said goodbye to the crocodile and continued their adventures, grateful for the new knowledge and memories they had gained from their encounter. Next, they went to South Australia, where they explored the dry deserts and the mighty Murray River. They both enjoyed splashing around in the cool waters of the Murray River and had a great time playing and exploring the area. As they continued their journey to South Australia, they stumbled upon a vast desert. They hopped through the dry sand, feeling the scorching heat on their fur. Just when they thought they would never find any sign of life in this barren land, they spotted a majestic emu strutting across the desert. The emu was an impressive sight, with its long legs and plumed feathers. The wallaby and the kangaroo were in awe as they watched the emu move gracefully through the desert. They were also intrigued by its speed, as the emu could run much faster than they could ever dream of. The two animal friends followed the emu from a distance, learning about the unique traits of this Australian bird. They discovered that the emu was one of the toughest birds and could withstand the harsh conditions of the desert. The wallaby and kangaroo were grateful for this new encounter and continued their journey, feeling excitement for the diversity of life in Australia. Finally, they headed to Victoria, where they explored the snowy mountains. Wally was a little intimidated by the cold and the snow, but Skip explained that they were well adapted for this kind of weather and that they would be just fine. They spent a few days playing in the snow, sliding down hills and building snowmen. Wally was amazed at how beautiful the world could be, even in the cold and snow. As our two friends, the wallaby and kangaroo, continued their journey through Victoria State, they eventually made it down from the snowy mountains and onto the coast. There, they met a majestic pelican who was gliding through the sky. The friends were fascinated by the bird's appearance and asked why it had such a large bill and a neck that could stretch out so far. The pelican chuckled and told them that he needed his big bill to hold the large fish that he caught, and his long neck helped him dive deep into the water to catch his seafood. The pelican also boasted about how he preferred to eat eels, flounders, and squids, and how he loved to live near the coast. The wallaby and kangaroo thanked the pelican for sharing his story. They continued on their journey, always in awe of the different animals and creatures that they would meet on their adventures. At the end of their journey, Wally and Skip were grateful for their friendship and the outstanding adventures they had shared. They returned home with a deeper understanding of the beauty and diversity of the world and a newfound sense of courage and confidence. They couldn't wait for their next adventure together. If you are ever in Australia, ask for Wally and Skip, and they will gladly show you around.